How's it going, guys? My name is Simon, and welcome to part 2 of my C# basic tutorial. Today we're going to take a look at variables inside of C#, and we're also going to make a little math program, like calculator, I think you can call it, where you can add or subtract numbers together. First off, just open Visual Studio and make a new project right here. We want to make a Windows Forms application, and be sure that you are in Visual C# over here. Then the name for it should be, just hold on for a second. Oh, you can see my mouse, that's great. We want to call it something. I will just call it part 2. No, we'll call it variables, like that. Okay. And we'll just wait a second. So variables basically is, if you remember from maths class, like, it is, you can assign a value to, like, a letter. For example, if you have the letter X, you can assign a number to it, and then use X instead of the number. That's kind of like how variables is. So we'll just go to the code first. So double click on the form, like that. There we go. So what we want to write is in this method here. You don't know what a method is yet, but bear with me. And we want to go down a bit, and then we want to create our first variable. So the variable will hold a number or text or whatever. You can think of it like a storage room, where you can throw in objects and then get them again, kind of like that. So we're going to first create a variable that can hold text. So in order to make that, we need to type string first, like that, because string is text in C#, and most other programming languages too. Then we want to press space and type the name of the variable. This could be whatever you want, rotten bananas, maybe. I can't even type. Or it can be something that you remember. I'll just call mine test. But this can be whatever you want. Now you can end with a semicolon. But now we have just created the variable. We haven't assigned any value to it. Like, we haven't assigned it any text to it. So in order to do that, we can go to new line and type test equals, and then the string, or the text. So, hello YouTube, like that. But we can't just write like that, because we'll get a bunch of errors here, as you see. We need to put them in, I don't remember what these are called, but it's shift and then 2, I think. It's for YouTube. But I'll probably write an annotation there. So after that, we want to type a semicolon, like that. And we need to use these because it's a string. It's just what you need to do that, else it won't work. So this is one way. So now we can just open the message box. Remember, mbox, press tab twice. And then instead of typing something in here, we can type test, like that. And when we run our program here, we will get a, hopefully, message box. Yeah. Hello YouTube, that's exactly what it should be. Okay, now we can close this. So we could use this method, or we could just assign it right here. So, like that, instead of this. So, now it's a bit shorter and a bit more easy. But if you want, like, if you want to hold a, you want the user to type in something and then store it in the test string, then you don't want to assign it like this. But whatever, this is the string. So yeah, we won't use that anymore in this tutorial. So we'll just delete that. I hope you remember it now. And now we're going to create a integer, which is a number, basically. So in order to make that, we need to type int for integer. And not integer like that. We need to type int only, then space. Then the name of the variable, which will be test for now. And then we can assign it the same way. We don't need these things. We only need to type the number. We can't have decimals in integers. So yeah, that went a bit quickly, but I hope you understood. So now we could have, now we can see an error here. We typed, or we named this the same, but it gives us an error. And that is because the message box can only display a string. So we need to convert it somehow. And in order to do that, it's, I think it's easiest to just type dot toString and then empty brackets after, like that. And that's just converting the variable to a string. So instead of 5, it will convert it to 5, but in a string instead, like that. Okay, whatever. So if you test this now, we will see 5. That's great. Now, I'm going to talk a bit about math operators and integers. So we will delete this, and we will rename this integer number 1, or num1, like that. And then we want to create another integer, so int num2 equals to 4, and then semicolon. And then we can show in parentheses num1 plus num2. Just a simple plus sign right there in between. And then, of course, we need to convert it to string. But I'm putting this in, I mean, brackets, because we need to do this first and then convert it to string. We can't take the number 1, convert it to string, and then add it to number 2. That doesn't work. So we need to do this before, and therefore I'm doing this in brackets. So, yeah. And when we run this, it should be 9. And it does. Great. So, now we can do the same with subtraction. Minus, just a minus sign like that. And we will get 1, like that. And we could do multiplied. And you need to type a asterisk, I think it's called. It's, yeah, I think you can find it. And that will multiply it by the second number. So 5 multiplied by 4 is 20. That's correct. And now we can actually make a small calculator out of this. So we just need to add a button here. You remember how to do that, hopefully. And then we will add a text box. If you can't see all this stuff, you probably need to press all Windows forms. And then we want to go to text box, add two text boxes. I'm just going to do this real quickly. We'll press the button and then go out, over to the properties and rename it to calculate, maybe, like that. And then we will go to the form thing. We'll delete this, double click on the button to make a new method. I know you don't know this, but we're just going to do this real quick. Just follow me. We want two integers, so we could write like this: integer and then space num1, comma num2. But we can't define them, so we need to do that on the second line. So num1 is equal to textbox1 dot text, because we need to get in to the text whatever is in here will be num1. Okay, we need to also convert that text to an integer, and that you do that by typing convert dot convert dot to int, not uint, int, like that. And then we put this in brackets, like that. So we'll just copy this, paste it, control C, control V, and then num2 instead. And we want to write or type textbox2. Then we want the message box to display, so mbox, tab twice. Now we want num1 plus num2, because we're going to use plus. Sorry. There we go. And then we need to convert it to a string. Right? Okay. If you haven't written this, just copy it now. Then we're going to run our program. And now we can put in a number here and a number here. So this should be 4 plus 1 equals 5. So now when we press calculate, it says 5. Okay, so that was pretty complicated, but I just wanted you to like create a program, because when you got how you do this, you can make almost whatever you want. So yeah, in the next tutorial, we're going to take a look at we're going to continue with the variables, and also I'm going to explain the text boxes, methods, and yeah, I think that's it for the next tutorial. But if you like this tutorial, please hit the like button and subscribe to me. It helps a lot for me to continue these tutorials. If you don't like the tutorial, then write why and dislike the video. So, whatever. See you guys next time.